It's just that the most annoying part is you ladies. When you see all these actors, you shout. You have forgotten that somebody paid for your ticket. He's sitting beside you like, oh my God, Desmond Elliott. The girl will look at you. He will now start hating Desmond Elliott for nothing. Or you see Ramsey now, oh my God, it's Ramsey. When I see him, I want to slap him. Where's Ramsey? See, I pay for a babe to come. He will now see, oh my God, it's Ramsey. Oh, she will start shaking. She did not shake like that for me. So I will personally just develop unnecessary, not hatred, bad belly for him. So if you see him, I say, ah, I know you. I say, I don't know you, my friend. But our movies are doing good. We're doing good. We're doing good. I believe they've recognized us. Look at all our actors. Gone are those days that you see our actors in movie driving Mercedes, and the next day they are in Mulwe. You know, I said, didn't I see Mercedes yesterday? But by the grace of God, if you see them in Mercedes today, they are driving Rolls Royce tomorrow, for real. Look at all of them. They're doing good. They are models. Ah, my brother, Pascal Atuma. What name? It is only Igbo people. They will be in America 40 years. The accent will not leave. Last December, I went to Lagos. They were asking Nigerians in diaspora who have been in diaspora. They were asking them, so you've been in diaspora for a long time. That means the culture has affected you, your kind of music, what you say. I said, nah, it is true. As you can see from my accent, man, I've been there for a long time. It has changed me. Say, so who is your favorite artist? He said, nah, it's Snoop Doggy Doggy. Dr. Ndiri. Boys 11 Man. As you can see, it has changed in my accent. That is Igbo man for you. Their accent will not change. And
I also know we have some white people here. Hi, how you doing? You all right? Are you understanding the joke? If you're not understanding, if you see them laughing, that means it's funny, okay? Just laugh. You don't need to get what I'm saying. Just laugh. That means whatever I'm saying is funny, okay? You know, I like white people. White people are the only ones in the world. Have you seen the attachment they have to the animals? If a white person wants to buy a dog, the full family will visit. Say, oh, today we're going to buy a dog, blah, 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 blah. They go to the dog place. They will see dog. Nkita. Hi. I am Sharon. Your name is going to be David. No, let me not use David. Where's John? Your name is going to be John, not Domelo John. I'm going to be your new mom. You have two brothers and a sister. Are you serious? Go to Akwa Ibom. You go to Akwa Ibom, now dogs, they carry their bags. Say, God, go punish you now. I'm leaving. Man.
I'm not playing with you. Uchu was terrible with callers back in the day. So what we did was that after a few years, I said, you know what, guys, let's all branch out. Let everybody go on their own for a minute. I think this Rat Pack thing is making us not fucking so well. Let's all go out there and see what the world has for us. So we went out. I went my own 4 years, you know, hustled the world, opened a few businesses, came back. You know, we're doing good. And then I came back. And boy, did I come back. And then I saw Uche. There was a transmutation. Uche went from the Rastafarian with big rainbow hats to black Kim Kardashian braids. And I said to myself, hold up, Jim. There's something you've been missing all these years. Oh my God, Uche, what happened to you? I'm telling you, Uche put it together, businesswoman, CEO. She had it going on. Uche was running things. I said, that's my sister. I mean, this is a good time to take her home to mom and say, you know what, I know you waited a while, but you know how to come with the best thing. And so, Uche, I'm sorry, baby, but this is what we did. We threw a dice between all three brothers, and we decided who was going to go. I won. So I was supposed to go with Austin Waller. Austin was supposed to go, and I was supposed to back him up. We're planning our move, you know, roll up in our new cars, tell each other, you know what, you're a woman, I'm a man, you're good, I'm good, we're successful, I'm successful. Let's take the world over. And then boom, the Puerto Rican happened. Dude came right before us under our own noses in our own backyard and stole our own. Dude waltzing in there with all that Latino charm. Looking good. Tight suit. Tight behind. And tight many other things and walked in and stole our own sister. I resent that. I'm not even gonna try to be a gentleman about this. I resent it. My brother lost a wife. The Puerto Rican gained a wife. You know, so the thing is that, tell Jose that I know some people that know some people that know some people. Let him don't step on Nigerian soil, come what may. I'm not playing with you. They think I'm playing. Baby, know me, I'm not playing. You hurt me, man. You hurt all of us, seriously. But I'm playing. Yeah, I was slow, man. For once in my life, I was slow. Now, the lesson of this story. You see her, she's good. She's good for her, man. Nail that deal. Look at her looking so good. Which is sweetheart. Give it up. Thank you.
Y'all don't watch Big Brothers. Is it Big Brother Africa? This is the only guy I wish what Uti did. Obama can do that. Uti went the first time, he failed. They drive and come out. Second time he went, he won the thing. That is one guy doing Nigerian proud. Uti, stand up, me they see you. Stand up. Stand up. Uti is a worry boy like me. With tight suits. God punish money.
But you see what I like about African movie? Is the fact that there are some things that would not happen in African movies because of our cultural background. Now, let me give you an example. It is only in foreign cultures that somebody wants to kill you and you will stay. There are some things that are not relevant to our culture. That is why. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Can you find a seat for Dumelo? Or relocate somebody so that they can sit down. Or somebody should shift. Or if you are in a seat, you need to relocate right now. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a round of applause for the coolest dude, John Dumelo. Thank you. See, we have come a long way. Gone are the days that you will see our actors and just say, ah, John, how funny. Now people are screaming for you like you gave them money. That's the thing I like. All these girls, they are screaming. When they get up, they'll go and use Advil. All because they are screaming for you. And I like the way they did that. They've learned Hollywood star. They two will come on stage. Look at Jimmy. I came on stage. We're like, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I saw they are learning it. We are there. I thank God for it. Look at my brother, Desmond Elliott. We used to model together. It's modeling days. But now, look at a big actor. He's wearing goggles. Hallelujah. Praise God. But you see, let me tell you. Forget anything they are saying about our movies. What I know is that our movies reflect our culture and they are taking us there. But let me tell you, even Oyibo movies, they have their own issues. It is only in Oyibo movies. Have you noticed that big as Nollywood is getting, we don't do horror movies. You know why? It does not reflect our culture. It is only Oyibo people that will be in the safe confinement of their house and something will be outside. You will go and look for it with torchlight. Something is, I say, John, did you hear that? In Africa, hello? Who is that? Oh my God, he said, Wolf, you are not time to run. Wolf will knock you. Who send you outside? Why don't you stay in your house and lock door? That is why it will not happen in Hollywood. If I'm in my house, something is outside, I'm under the table. Police, so yeah. Something is outside, though. Even if it is wind blowing your door. There are some things that we cannot be stupid enough to do. For instance, Indian movie. Somebody wants to kill you, and you know, he's with a gun. He will be singing, and you will be dancing. And you know he's going to kill you. And you are saying Nollywood. The guy will come with his gun. Adam Sate. I am going to kill you. You will now start to sing. You two say, Are.
Acha.
The funniest thing is, he wants to kill you. They will start drumming. You're not dancing. He will dance until you now say, Adam Sate. She say, Ah, ma, which your ma? Didn't you see when he was pointing the gun? That is why Nollywood is ahead. The next one, Chinese movie.
I need your support, y'all. Then secondly, should I not talk about my fellow celebs? Should I keep it clean? And bear in mind, though, before you answer that, I have the inside story on every one of them sitting here. Everybody, there's no exception. I could keep it low, all the stuff you read on the blogs, on the social medias, on the papers, both print and electronic. I can give you the real insight on all of that. So should I talk about them or not? Including yours sincerely, I'm no exception to this game. I can go ahead. And then they said I should not make any political statement. Yes or no? Now that's a divided house now. I need to make sure I'm hearing the right thing. It's the people's choice, y'all. Should I or should I not? I'm sure a vast number of you know that. Huh? I'm sorry, guys, it's not part of you guys all because of looking good in VIP. I'm not referring to you with all due respect, my profuse apologies. The guys up there, should I or should I not? Done. That girl in pink said, what did you say, honey? Not. Honey, I see a whole bunch of girls up in there. Did you come with a man? No? Y'all came alone? There's a clinical situation here. I hear a brother threatening me from the back. Let me tell you what's happening. Your guys woke up in the morning and said, you know what, baby, you know, we're going for this award. But that psycho G Mike is going to be hosting it. So here's what's going to happen. I'm going to roll out my boys. Y'all roll out with your girls. So it's such a behind up in there. I bet your men are all sitting on VIP right now. So what y'all got to do? I'll give you the same advice I give my sisters. Kick him to the curbs. He does not deserve you. Look at you looking all so hot and sitting up in there. And the brother's trying to avoid your eyes. Because I want to sit next to your jumbo. Well, that's not what's going to happen.
Guillermo Awards, October 19, 2013.
On October 19, 2013, announcing the second annual
Golden Icons Academy Movie Awards,
Guillama, right here in Houston, Texas.
You have to be there.
So don't miss out. Get your tickets on time at www.guillamaawards.com. Seats are limited and guaranteed to be sold out. Again,
log on to www.guillamaawards.com.
And so, which I'm sorry, baby, but this is what we did. We threw a dice between our three brothers and we decided who was going to go. Ice won. So Ice was supposed to go with Austin won. Austin was supposed to go and I was supposed to back him up. We were planning our move, you know, roll up in our new cars, tell each other, you know what, you're a woman, I'm a man, you're good, I'm good, we're successful, I'm successful. Let's take the world over. And then boom, the Puerto Rican happened. Dude came right before us under our own noses in our own backyard and stole our own. Dude waltzing in there with all that Latino charm. Looking good. Tight suit. Tight behind. And tight many other things and walked in and stole our own sister. I resent that. I'm not even gonna try to be a gentleman about this. I resent it. My brother lost a wife. The Puerto Rican gained a wife. You know, so the thing is that, tell Jose that I know some people that know some people that know some people. Let him don't step on Nigerian soil, come what may. I'm not playing with you. They think I'm playing. Babe, you know me, I'm not playing. You hurt me, man. You hurt all of us, seriously. But I'm playing. Yeah, I was slow, man. For once in my life, I was slow. Now, the lesson of this story. You see her, she's good. She's good for her, man. Nail that deal. Look at her looking so good. Which is sweetheart. Give it up. Thank you.
Y'all don't watch Big Brothers. Is it Big Brother Africa? This is the only guy I wish what Uti did. Obama can do that. Uti went the first time. He failed. They drive and come out. Second time he went, he won the thing. That is one guy doing Nigerian proud. Uti, stand up, me they see you. Stand up. Stand up. Uti is a worry boy like me. With tight suits. God punish money.
But you see, what I like about African movie is the fact that there are some things that would not happen in African movies because of our cultural background. Now, let me give you an example. It is only in foreign cultures that somebody wants to kill you and you will stay. There are some things that are not relevant to our culture. That is why. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Can you find a seat for Dumelo? Or relocate somebody so that they can sit down. Or somebody should shift. Or if you are in a seat, you need to relocate right now. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, a round of applause for the coolest dude, John Dumelo. Thank you. See, we have come a long way. Gone are the days that you will see our actors, I'll just say, ah, John, how about you? Now people are screaming for you like you gave them money. That's the thing I like. All these girls, they are screaming. When they get home, they'll go and use Advil. All because they are screaming for you. And I like the way they've learned Hollywood star. They two will come on stage. Look at Jimmy, I came on stage, we're like, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I saw they are learning it. We are there. Thank God for that. Look at my brother, Desmond Elliot. We used to model together. It's modeling days, but now look at a big actor. He's wearing goggles. Hallelujah. Praise God. But you see, let me tell you, forget anything they are saying about our movies. What I know is that our movies reflect our culture and they are taking us there. But let me tell you, even Oyibo movies, they have their own issues. It is only in Oyibo movies. Have you noticed that? Big as Nollywood is getting, we don't do horror movies. You know why? It does not reflect our culture. It is only Oyibo people that will be in the... It's just that the most annoying part is you ladies. When you see all these actors, you shout. You have forgotten that somebody paid for your ticket. He's sitting beside you like, oh my God, Desmond Elliot. The guy will look at you. He will now start hating Desmond Elliot for nothing. Or you see Ramsey now, oh my God, it's Ramsey! When I see him, I want to slap him. Where's Ramsey? See, I pay for a babe to come. You will now see, oh my God, it's Ramsey. Oh, she will start shaking. She did not shake like that for me. So I will personally just develop unnecessary, not hatred, bad belly for him. So if you see him, I say, ha, I know you. I don't know you, my friend. But our movies are doing good. We're doing good. We're doing good. I believe they've recognized us. Look at all our actors. Gone are those days that you see our actors in movie driving Mercedes, and the next day they are in Mulwe. You know, I said, didn't I see Mercedes yesterday? But by the grace of God, if you see them in Mercedes today, they are driving Rolls Royce tomorrow, for real. Look at all of them. They're doing good. They are models. Ah, my brother, Pascal Atuma. What name? It is only Igbo people. They will be in America 40 years. The accent will not leave. Last December, I went to Lagos. They were asking Nigerians in diaspora who have been in diaspora. They were asking them, so you've been in diaspora for a long time. That means the culture has affected you, your kind of music, what you say. I said, nah, it is true. As you can see from my accent, man, I've been there for a long time. It has changed me. Say, so who is your favorite artist? He said, nah, it's Snoop Doggy Doggy. Dr. Ndiri. Boys 11 Man. As you can see, it has changed in my accent. That is Igbo man for you. Their accent will not change. And
I also know we have some white people here. Hi, how you doing? You alright? Are you understanding the joke? If you're not understanding it, if you see them laughing, that means it's funny, okay? Just laugh. You don't need to get what I'm saying. Just laugh. That means whatever I'm saying is
safe confinement of your house, and something will be outside. You will go and look for it with torchlight. Something is. I say, John, did you hear that? You not take a hello? Who is that? Oh my God! It's a wolf. You are not trying to run. Wolf will knock you. Who send you outside? Why don't you stay in your house and lock door? That is why it will not happen in Hollywood. If I'm in my house, something is outside, I'm under the table, police, so yeah. Something is outside though, even if it is wind blowing your door. There are some things that we cannot be stupid enough to do. For instance, Indian movie. Somebody wants to kill you and you know, he's with a gun. He will be singing and you will be dancing. And you know he's going to kill you. And you are saying Nollywood, the guy will come with his gun. Adam Sate. I am going to kill you. You will now start to sing. You two say, Are. Acha. The funniest thing is, he wants to kill you. They will start drumming. You now dancing. He will dance until you say, Adam Sate. She said, ah, ma, which your ma? Did you see when he was pointing the gun? That is why Nollywood is ahead. The next one, Chinese movie.
I need your support, y'all. Then secondly, should I not talk about my fellow celebs? Should I keep it clean? And bear in mind, though, before you answer that, I have the inside story on every one of them sitting here. Everybody. There's no exception. I could keep it low. All the stuff you read on the blogs, on the social medias, on the papers, both print and electronic, I can give you the real insight on all of that. So should I talk about them or not? Including yours sincerely. I'm no exception to this game. I can go ahead. And then they said I should not make any political statement.
Funny, okay? You know, I like white people. White people are the only ones in the world. Have you seen the attachment they have to the animals? If a white person wants to buy a dog, the full family will visit. Say, oh, today we're going to buy a dog, blah, 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 blah. They go to the dog place. They will see dog. Nkita.
Hi. I am Sharon. Your name is going to be David.
No, let me not use David. Where is John?
Your name is gonna be John, not Tomato John. I'm gonna be your new mom. You have two brothers and a sister. Are you serious? Go to Akwa Ibom. You go to Akwa Ibom, now dogs, they carry their bags. Say, God, go punish you now. I'm leaving. Man.
I'm not playing with you. Uchi was terrible with callers back in the day.
So what we did was that after a few years, I said, you know what, guys, let's all branch out. Let everybody go on their own for a minute. I think this Rat Pack thing is making us not fucking so well. Let's all go out there and see what the world has for us. So we went out. I went my own 4 years, you know, hustled the world, opened a few businesses, came back. You know, we're doing good. And then I came back. And boy, did I come back. And then I saw Uche. There was a transmutation. Uche went from the Rastafarian with big rainbow hats to black Kim Kardashian braids. And I said to myself, hold up, Jim. There's something you've been missing all these years. Oh my God, Uche, what happened to you? I'm telling you, Uche put it together, businesswoman, CEO. She had it going on. Uche was running things. I said, that's my sister. I mean, this is a good time to take her home to mom and say, you know what, I know you waited a while, but you know how to come with the best thing.